Hello.
There you go.
Good evening, Sister Vivia.
Yes, sir. Good evening.
Bless you. Let me just finish set up this. I'm just setting up this.
Yeah, let myself. I'm setting up where I am here too.
Right. How are
So,
you doing? Happy New Year.
happy return.
I've not seen you from last year.
You know, from last year, you got that right.
Yes, I'm correct. Last year is a long time, you know.
I want you to see just my right there. Good.
Wonderful, wonderful. Actually, we are streaming live right now.
Okay.
Praise God. Okay, I gotta start right now until the rest of the persons come in. All right, good evening, everyone. God bless you and welcome this evening to our, for the first time this year in year 2022, we are going live on the Crossroad Youth Encounter. Truly, God is amazing. God has been good to us. We have been so blessed of God. God has kept us, and we are truly rejoicing to be alive and well in the land of the living. We also trust in God that this year will be a tremendous one of mighty breakthroughs, great deliverance, the hand of God touching here and there. We're expecting that this year, young people will come to know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and that evangelism will be directed in their path, that they too will come to know Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. So we want to turn a spotlight on the younger generation across the world, that they too will come in alliance, in agreement, in step, walking with God. And we are sure that there's so many young people across the world who indeed really want to serve and to follow Jesus Christ. We want to be there for them. We want to be there to give them that energy, that strength that they need, that push in their life that they can make it. And truly, we believe God for them. There are some wonderful young people out there that truly love God. There's some young people in many, many churches across the world, right here in Florida, those in Jamaica, praise God, in Jamaica, in Canada, in England, in Russia, in different areas of the world. And we're trusting God that this year, truly, some amazing things will happen in the country where young people are gathered. And so we are trusting God that revival will come to the young people and that the pastors and the bishops and the elders and the deacons and the missionaries and the exhorters will put all resources and energy and time and effort in reaching to the young people of our generation. We are really looking forward to indeed a mighty, mighty move of God. Oh, praise God. Let me take time out to welcome with us this evening Evangelist Sandra Shepherd, and of course, Sister Vivia Nicholson with us this evening in the studio. We are so happy. And also, we have Isaiah and Tiana. Amen. Happy New Year, everybody, and welcome. And to all our viewers who are watching on the Zoom and on the Facebook, God bless you. And we're so happy to have you with us at this time. At this time, it's my honor, my privilege to turn over the rest of the service to our, let me just do what I need to do here. Our co-host, Evangelist Sandra Shepherd. Make her welcome.
God bless you, man of God. God bless you.
God bless
First,
you
I just
too.
want to say Happy New Year to our listening, our viewing audience, and to you, Pastor Steadman, and they have Sister Vivian Nicholson on,
Our
and
songbird is in us.
yes, and Sister and Brother Isaiah and little Tiana is on with us. So I just want to say a warm welcome.
Amen.
As you
Praise
can
God.
see, I'm in the confines of my room because I'm not feeling well, so I have to be quarantined. So I know.
And we're believing God for your complete healing, total healing.
Yes, glory to God. Hallelujah. Tonight, I want to greet the Holy Spirit who is ahead of my life. Then I just want to greet each and every one tonight on the platform, all our listening audiences all across on YouTube, Facebook, or whatever platform you're listening from. Welcome back to Crossroad Youth Encounter. We took 2 weeks break because of the holiday period, but to God be the glory, we are back. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise God.
And without any further ado, we just go straight into our program, and I will just ask Pastor Steadman to pray for us in Jesus' name.
Let us pray. Our gracious God, our Father, in the name of Jesus, we give a praise and glory. We worship you, knowing, oh God, that you are the true and living God. There is indeed no God like Jehovah, who can be compared to him. The many have made false God, the work of man's invention, as their gods. But we know that you are the true and living God, the author and the finisher of our faith, the rock upon which we stand, our hope, our life, our joy, and the power that keeps us going, because in you we move and live and have our being. Lord, we thank you for Evangelist Sandra Shepherd. We thank you for Sister Viva Nicholson. We thank you for Sister Minister Sadie Campbell. We thank you for Isaiah and Tiana. We thank you, Lord, for all our viewers, our listeners across the world. May the mighty hand of God continue to rest upon every soul, especially young people across the nations of the world. Divine God, have your own way this evening. Let no flesh glory in your presence. Receive all the praise and the glory tonight as we magnify you, bless you. We thank you, God, for what you're about to do on this program tonight. Lord, let somebody feel the touch of the Master's hand, a life change. Somebody, my God, come to know you as a personal Lord and Savior. Have your own way, Father, as we magnify you, bless you, and give you all the praise in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody say amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, praise Jesus. God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Pastor Steadman, for praying for us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And as you said, Sister, her name is Evangelist Vivia.
I'm just the Joy Nicholson.
Okay, Sister Joy Nichols. Okay, then.
Sister
Joy Nichols, this time, I just wanted to grace the platform with a song for us. Hallelujah. Just give us a song. Let's just start off with a song for now. Just that for now from you, sister. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Greetings, everyone, in the mighty name of Jesus, and Happy New Year. Hitherto has the Lord helped us. We have made it over to 2022, and we are grateful to God for his many blessings. Tonight, I just want to sing this old hymn. I like the hymns. Saying to the Lord, pass us not, but hear our gentle cry. While on others you are passing, Lord, do not pass us by.
Hallelujah.
Pass me not, O gentle Savior, in my humble cry, while on others calling, do not pass me by.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah. Savior, my Lord, hear my humble cry. Oh, why on others thou art calling, oh, do not pass pass me by.
Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let me at thy throne of mercy. Oh, find a sweet relief in my wounded, broken spirit. Oh, help my unbelief.
Come on, sing it.
Sing it, Savior, Savior.
My Lord,
hear my humble, hear my humble cry. Oh, why on others thou art calling?
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Do not pass us by.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah. Amen, Jesus. Glory to God. Mighty
wonderful,
God.
Wonderful.
While on others thou art calling. Hallelujah.
Do not pass me by.
Do not pass us by. Glory to God. As we have entered a new year. Hallelujah. Yes. Glory to God. We are just basking in the presence of Almighty God. Hallelujah. Yes. And it is our plea, hallelujah, that he should not pass us by. No matter what. While on others thou art calling, do not pass us by.
Do not.
Stay with us, mighty God. Yes. Keep us. Yes. Continue to watch over us. Continue, mighty God, to guide and protect and keep us, Lord, as the apple of thine eyes. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. At this time, we have little Isaiah and Tiana, and I think they're gonna come and read and do the devotion for us. After that, we'll have little sister Taya singing for us. Glory to God. Excuse me, sorry about that. Hold on a minute for me. Little Isaiah, could you please hold on for me, please? Sorry about that, we did not do the welcome. So at this time, Sister Sadie will be coming forth with a welcome. God bless you. I forgot Amen. About the welcome. Just make us all welcome, even though we did. Sorry about that.
Praise God. The mic is on mute, Sister Sadie. Your mic is on mute.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
I was trying to get it, but it just shut the iPad down. Oh, greetings, everyone. It's a blessing for us to be here to come together again at this time in the 2020. As somebody was saying today, they saw the 2020. It's not 2020. It has two zeros and it has a two. So it's 2022. But all we have to say, thank God, in spite of our difficulties, our challenges, he has brought us over into 2022. And we're looking forward to a prosperous and a wonderful year if the Lord's tarry with us.
Amen.
Because what is going on? we have to be saying, if the Lord's tarry, because I have never seen so much killing in Canada at such a short time. Today is the seventh day, and we have about 10 murders already.
My goodness.
So we know the coming of the Lord is close, because when he said, when you see these things, sign and wonders, look up, for our redemption draw at night. Okay.
That's it. That's it.
I just want to offer my welcome to each and every one here. Offer to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving and perform your vows to the Most High and call upon him in the days of trouble. I will deliver you and you shall glorify me. That's what for my, that's our New Year resolution. I want to honor the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit who's head of my life. A pleasant good night to our host, Pastor Eric Steadman, co-host, Evangelist Sandra Shepherd, and all the other pastors and ministers, first timers, listeners, regular online listeners, those on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and all the media platform where it has been live streamed. Welcome, welcome each and everyone. Welcome again, each and everyone, to another night in the first night in the new year of 2020, our Crossroad Youth Encounter, where the name of Jesus is being lifted up. Come with great expectation to receive a word, a blessing from the Lord, who is the creator of heaven and earth. Come with your cups turned up as we cry out to God for help. Sit and enjoy the blessing with us. How precious are your thoughts about me? Oh God, they cannot be numbered. I can't even count them. They counted the grains of sand, and when I woke up, are still with me. That's Psalms 139, 17 and 18. God bless you all. Have a wonderful night.
Amen.
God bless you, Minister Sadie, for that warm welcome. And I know that all our listeners tonight, they felt that welcome. And they know that the welcome comes straight from the heart. And it's a blessing and a privilege to be here again. And at this time, I'll just ask Brother Little Isaiah and Little
Tiana,
yes, to do the devotion for us.
Today I'll be reading John 1 to 9, and Tiana will be reading 10 to 18. The Word became flesh. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. For 2022, we need to believe and trust in God. Many of God's created ones do not believe in Jesus, but we must believe in him.
He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John testifies concerning him. He cries out, saying, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me has surpassed me, because he was for me.' From the fullness of his grace, we have all received one blessing after another. For the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but God, the one and only, who is at the Father's side, has made him known." Here ends a portion of God's reading. We honor it by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just want to thank young Isaiah and young Tiana for doing the scripture reading devotion for us. And as the Bible says, it says a child shall lead the way. And these are young children doing the work of Almighty God. And as we are in Crossroad in Youth Encounter, we just want to implore them and to just let them feel that they are precious in the sight, yes, of Almighty God. And it says, the Bible says, whatever they do, it is precious in his sight. So I just want to say a big thank you to little Isaiah and Tiana tonight for doing the scripture for us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes. I just want to make welcome again on the Zoom platform. Hallelujah. We have Brother J.R. Hallelujah. Sister Minister Sadie Campbell, Sister Joy Nicholson, little Isaiah, Taya, Tiana, and our host, glory to God, the man of the moment, hallelujah, Pastor Eric Steadman. And to all those who are watching on Facebook, hallelujah, we have Pastor Charlene Evans, Sister Olive Spencer, Sister Dahlia Watt, Sister Natalie Bartlett, Sister Janice Small, glory to God, and all the others. Even if I did not call your name, I just want to say a warm welcome to you all. Hallelujah. Glory to
Sister God. Maureen Hallelujah. Smith.
Pardon me?
Sister Maureen Smith.
Okay, and Sister Maureen Smith. Hallelujah.
We have some persons watching, even from one of the churches back in St. Elizabeth. Sister Sashika Mullins is watching. Good. And we have Sister Natalie Barrett watching, as well as Clearly Stubbs. Welcome, welcome to Crossroad Youth Encounter. May you be blessed.
Amen. Glory to God. Each week as we come, we are here, glory to God, to encourage youths across the world. We see what is happening in our world today. When we look in the churches, the youths are missing. Glory to God. And it is our endeavor. We take it upon ourselves to call back the youth and let them realize that they are precious in the sight of Almighty God. And no matter what they have been through, don't allow the things of this world or what people say to let you feel as if you're cast out and you're not accepted. Glory to God. But just to know that you are precious in the sight of Almighty God, and God loves you with an everlasting love. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And at this time, Minister Chevron will be coming to pray for the countries, beginning with the letter B.
Brother Chevron, can you hear us? Sister Sadie, could you give us the countries that start with the letter B, Barbados and
I didn't prepare for B. I have A, like unted. We were starting over. So it's...
So we said A already.
No, we didn't. We didn't get into it last time, no. No, you're missing. It's A we're starting with tonight.
Okay.
Okay then, sister.
Sorry. What we have? Algeria, Accolade, Amsterdam, Antens, and Auckland.
Okay then. So at this time, Minister Siobhan will be coming to pray for the countries beginning with A.
Can you hear me?
Yes, Brother Siobhan.
Praise God, praise God. Good night, everyone. A blessed night to everybody. Tonight I come. Heavenly Father, we worship you, we glorify you, we lift you on high, Almighty God. We give you all the honor, all the praise, Almighty God. Heavenly Father, as I come, Almighty God, nothing in my hands I bring, except to the humble cross I cling. Heavenly Father, I ask that you forgive me for the sins I've committed, whether in thought, deeds, or action. Oh, Heavenly Father, search me, and anything that is in my heart that is not of you, Almighty God, I ask that you remove it and you send it back to the pits of hell. And Heavenly Father, as the psalmist David said, create in me a clean and pure heart, Almighty God. And Heavenly Father, if there's anything that is in me, any unforgiveness, any bitterness, anything, Almighty God, I ask that you remove it. As I come, O merciful Father, to lift up the youth in the countries, beginning with the letter A, Almighty God. And anything, Heavenly Father, that will block my prayer from going up to your throne room, I ask, Almighty God, that you will remove it. Heavenly Father, as I come, Almighty God, standing in the gap, lifting up these youth, Almighty God, you know everything about each of these youth. You know how many youth is there in each country, Almighty God. And as Minister Sadie just mentioned the names, oh Heavenly Father, we lift these youth to you. Heavenly Father, they are created. They were created by you for your purpose, Almighty God. And Heavenly Father, oftentimes, oh merciful Father, we forget that you are the creator of all things, including us, Almighty God. And tonight we lift up these youth to you, O Heavenly Father. We ask that you will protect them. We ask, Almighty God, that you will guide them. We ask, O merciful Father, that you will continue to abide with them, O merciful Father. Heavenly Father, we ask for knowledge, wisdom, and understanding to befall upon these youth, Almighty God. And Heavenly Father, you are the way maker. You sit high and you look low. And this evening, Almighty God, we lift up these youth to you. Heavenly Father, you know every circumstances, every situation that these youth might encounter, Almighty God. And Heavenly Father, we ask that you will provide a way for them, O merciful Father. And Heavenly Father, any of them, O merciful Father, we come against depression. We come against suicidal thoughts, Almighty God. We come against it in the mighty name of Jesus. And any plans, any trap that the enemy may have for these youth, Almighty God, we cancel it in your mighty name, O merciful Father. Cover their pathway, O merciful Father. And as Heavenly Father, as the scripture came, you came to be the light. So Heavenly Father, we ask that you will continue to be the light in these youth way, O merciful Father. Sometimes they are at a crossroad. Sometimes they are in a dark pass, O merciful Father.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Your light will shine, O merciful Father. And we ask that you will cover them, Almighty God. And Heavenly Father, let them know, O merciful Father, your word said you call them to be the head and not the tail. And
yes,
tonight,
Lord,
we lift them to you, Almighty God, to cover them, O merciful Father. Anoint them, O merciful Father. Heavenly Father, where there's any sickness, oh merciful Father, we ask for your healing touch, oh merciful Father. And Heavenly Father, we ask, oh merciful Father, that you will lift the families to these youth, oh merciful Father.
Yes,
Lord. Parents, oh merciful Father, we ask for parental guidance, oh merciful Father. Mm. Heavenly Father, we come, oh merciful Father, against the slumbering spirit, oh merciful Father, as these youth, oh merciful Father, are in school, oh merciful Father. We ask for wisdom, oh merciful Father. And we ask, oh merciful Father, that they will know that they can be anything, oh merciful Father, that you call them to be, oh merciful Father. All they need to do is trust and to believe, oh mighty God. And Heavenly Father, we lift them to you. Heavenly Father, we lift up the parents to you for parental guidance. Please, Heavenly Father, we lift them to you that you will make a way for these parents, oh merciful Father. Heavenly Father, yes, oftentimes, Lord. Oh merciful Father, we know they are there and they want to provide, but sometimes it's difficult, almighty God, but we lift them to you, oh merciful Father. And Heavenly Father, we just ask that you will cover them, almighty God. Cover them, Heavenly Father, with your blood. Heavenly Father, any road, anywhere that these youth go, oh merciful Father, we pray that your blood covering will be up on them, almighty God. Heavenly Father, we bless your holy name. We honor you, almighty God. And we thank you for the answered prayer. We thank you, almighty God, that you hear and you answer, almighty God. And we lift up these youth to you. And Heavenly Father, we pray, oh merciful Father, for their salvation. Heavenly Father, for those who don't know you as Lord and Savior, we pray, oh merciful Father, that they will come to know that you are the way maker. Almighty God, we give you praise. We give you honor tonight. And it's in Jesus' name that I pray and tell you thanks. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Glory Amen. To God. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Glory Jesus. To God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Minister Siobhan McClellan, for praying. Mighty God. Glory to God. God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. At this time, glory to God, we have Sister Joy Nicholson with us. And I'll just ask her to just give us an exhortation or a testimony or an encouragement for the youth. This is we have started a new year. And I know as a mother, there is something that she will give us a word that can encourage a young person listening this afternoon and to let them know that no matter what, God is able.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good night, everyone, and good night, especially to the young people in the listening audience. I come with no new news or message, but still to exalt the name of Jesus.
That's it.
So, as we just celebrated the birth of Jesus Christ, it brought me back to the name of Jesus. I sat one day and I was thinking about the name of Jesus. It is the one name given throughout mm-hmm. the entire stratosphere of the earth that does what no other name is capable and able to do. The name of Jesus. I'm excited about that name. And young people, I know you're out there and you are hearing all different kind of buzz. People saying this, people saying that, people exalting this, people demoting that. But I want to say to you tonight that one name that surpasses every other name still mm-hmm. have the power to keep you even in a time like this, a world today where you have the pandemic and so much buzzing. I want to say to you tonight, know the name of Jesus. Get to know who this person is. There are a few things I can say about him. It's the one name that brings deliverance. Yes. It's the one name that brings Amen. Salvation.
Glory it's to God. Hallelujah.
That brings healing. It's the yes. one person that don't judge you according to your sin. It's the one name that can erase sin. And I am encouraging you tonight, get to know the man Christ Jesus. I know that it is hard. And as a mother, I can say to you, and especially to some of those single mothers out there, get to know Jesus. He is still the source. He still has the ability to get you out of whatever situation that you might find yourself into. And most of these young folks, they have driven, they have departed from the faith. They are gone out there into the world doing all different kind of things. But that same name, that exalted name of Jesus,
yes,
and arms are still out there standing up as a good father, waiting to embrace you, to bring you back into himself. Get to know the name of Jesus. I'm excited, yes, about the name. The name of Jesus is powerful. It is the one name that even the vilest of sinner can come into that name and be free of all their sins.
Mm-hmm.
It's,
amen,
one name. It has the power to forgive sins, like I said. It has the power to heal. It has the power to save. Get to know Jesus for yourself. He does not change. He cannot change. His words remain a yea and amen. Get to know Jesus. Get, yes, to know Jesus. He is still the savior of the world. He will return as the frowning judge. Get to know him, walk with him, live for him, give up the pleasures of the world, allow him to give you the strength so that you can stay connected and stick, yes, to the vine, so that when he returns as the frowning judge, he will not cast you away from his presence, but he will still be standing with those outstretched arms to say to you, welcome, my friend, welcome, my child. Young people, if you trace the history of Jesus Christ, he started preaching when he was very young.
Yes,
and the words Ecclesiastes say, young man, I call upon you because you are strong. Young people, you are strong. You are vibrant. When I look sometime on social media and see the different things that most of our young people are engaged in, yes, that is the reason why the Lord says, seek me now while you're young, before you get caught up with all the different affairs of the world. Young persons, tonight I am imploring you, get to know the Lord. He is a true friend. There are so many of you out there who don't know the real love of a mother. Jesus can be the mother to the motherless. He can be the father to the fatherless.
My God.
The church, he can be barrister. When you get in trouble, you can go to him. He always stand with open arms to welcome and to embrace. Get to
my
know
God.
And Christ Jesus. Little Isaiah and Tiana, they are right there. They could have found so much different things on a Friday, mm-hmm, to do, yet they took time out, giving their themselves to the hour, to the time, to help, to put the gospel out there so that you can know. A lot of mothers today don't allow the kids, when they want to be baptized, to baptize, saying that they are young. They are not young to do get into trouble. They are not young to kill. They are not young to have babies.
My God.
No, no.
Bring, say that again, my sister. Jesus. Say it again.
Bring,
my God, somebody need to hear that.
Friend, some of you keeping them away from the church, keeping them away from the Lord. Push your children to Jesus Christ,
yes,
because if they don't need him today, they are going to need him tomorrow. It's a dreadful word out there, but the man Christ Jesus is any little girl's keeper. It's,
yes,
any little boy's keeper. He can train you. He can build you. He can give you the spirit of boldness so that you can stand. Push your children to Jesus and let them get to know him. Give them the Bible instead of,
yes,
buying the gadgets for them to go on there and explore behind your back when you're not seeing them when they are doing it. Give the Bible to them and let,
my
them
God,
read
the best present they can ever get. That's
Jesus.
The best present
because
they can get.
Everybody needs Jesus. We need Jesus, and we need to point our children and young people to Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Because,
yes, hallelujah.
He came, he died, and like the song that I said, but he nailed everything that we could have ever do or done in this life. He nailed every one of them to the cross, and he carried them with him
to the cross and he laid them there on the cross for us. Get your children closer to Jesus. Bring them to the Lord. Some of you,
my God,
old children, you're holding them back. You're keeping them away from getting to know the Lord. Push them into the face of Jesus. He said, suffer the little children to come unto me.
Come unto me.
And forbid them not. For such is the kingdom
of
heaven. Young people, I don't know what else to say to you. I started serving the Lord from I was in high school when everybody was giggling and laughing. I was taking all the time out to know Jesus for myself. And I can tell you, he had been my keeper through high school, after high school, until I became adult, young adult, old adult, and until this point, until this time today. And he had never failed me. There is not one word written in our good Bible, the book, that and any account where anybody said that when they wanted the Lord or when they called on the Lord, he did not. Or he did
Come on, my God.
There is not one
account. Never. There's never
the word.
My God.
He is our true champion. He is our true champion.
Yes.
He is a true leader.
Our undefeated heavyweight champion.
No, sir. Heavyweight champion of the world.
Jesus.
Our Jesus Christ. I am pleased tonight. I feel proud tonight. I am not ashamed of him tonight. Because he's
my God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Fear. He'll be ashamed to own you before his Father. So take on the name of Jesus, man. Take the name of Jesus with you,
child of sorrow and of woe.
It will joy and comfort bring you.
Take him everywhere you go. My God.
Oh, sweet hope of earth and joy of heaven. Take the name of Jesus with you, people. Young people, get to know Jesus Christ for yourself. I have no other message to give you. Only to say to you, the name of Jesus remains with the same power and the same might as it was in the days of old. And
the same
Jesus is able and he is capable of leading you safely home. God bless you tonight. And as we start the new year, get to know Jesus. That's my message. Get to know Jesus, because
hallelujah, that's the message, man.
Eternal, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Glory to know him is life eternal. Get to know him.
Hallelujah.
My God,
my God, that's a message. Get to know Jesus, and at this time, I don't want Sister Taya think I forget her. You know, I don't forget you, know, Sister Taya. Taya, you're gonna come now. Hallelujah. You're gonna sing for us after that powerful word. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Mighty God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Get to know Jesus. So a little young lady is gonna come now and sing for us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus.
While Taya is getting ready, for those who are watching online, God bless and welcome everyone that is watching. And if you feel so led that you want to come and share a word, a song, you have some poems, you want to do something for the Lord, right there on the Facebook page, you can come right in. Could you put it up, Evangelist, the meeting ID and the passcode? For those who might want to join in, I'm sure they're stirred up by the message, get to know Jesus. And I'm sure that they want to say something or do something for the Lord. Amen. Again, a big welcome to all those whose names have not been called. We want to thank God for Sister Yasin Thompson, Sister Anjali Robinson, Sister Primrose Peter, Evangelist Sandy, Sister Odette Sinclair, Sister Kim Taylor, my good friend, Sister Cheryl Green is watching, and all the other saints. So happy to have you with us. At this time, Mikataya is going to bless us.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Your mic is muted.
Have mercy, O Lord, down on my knees as I pray, Lord. Keep me safe, Lord. Have mercy, O Lord, down on my knees as I pray, Lord. Keep me safe, keep me was. I don't really want my pain. You know it's such a lot. And you look at times and never been alone. Never forsake you, Lord. I know you hear my prayer. If you promise me that everything will be okay. I will cry. Yeah, you listen to me. You listen to me. Many times I face, I remember my way. I remember that every Lord. Have mercy, oh me, Lord. Down on my knees as I pray, Lord. Keep me safe, Lord. Have mercy, oh me, Lord. Down on my knees as I pray, Lord. Keep me safe, keep me, Lord. One more chance, please hear me. One more chance, please have mercy. One more chance, love me. One more chance, and never see the same. With all the need from you, Lord. Have mercy, oh me, Lord. Down on my knees as I pray, Lord. Keep me safe, Lord. Have mercy, oh me, Lord. Down on my knees as I pray, Lord. Keep me safe, Lord. You come to us a child, Lord. Heal sickness of today. Hear my voice coming behind the bar. Ooh. Namaste, you're my blood, Lord. You're my shield, my protector. Every day. Lord, have mercy on me, Lord. Down on my knees as I pray, Lord. Keep me safe, Lord. Have mercy on me, Lord. Down on my knees as I pray, Lord. Keep me safe, keep me, Lord.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Sister Taya. Hallelujah. That's a message and it's also a prayer. Down on my knees, Lord. Keep me safe as I pray, Lord. Little Taya, she's asking the Lord to keep her safe.
Yes.
Down on her knees as she pray. So many of us, mighty God, sometimes we don't even have time to pray. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But she's reminding us tonight in that song.
Yes.
For the Lord to have mercy upon her and keep her safe down on her knees. She's asking for the Lord's protection over her, mighty God. And that's, oh God, something that we all need to exemplify or to ask the Lord to keep us safe.
Yes.
And to watch over us and protect us. Hallelujah. So many times we wake up and we get so busy.
Mm-hmm.
We can't even find time to pray, mighty God. But little Taya is reminding us tonight. Glory to God. Hallelujah. To keep her safe. Down on her knees. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Wonderful.
Glory to God. As I was going through my Bible here, the scripture that came to me is, we all know this passage of scripture. It is Ecclesiastic 12. Hallelujah. And I'm just going to read a few verses. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Yes, Sister Olive. Thank you. I look forward to seeing you next week. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says, Ecclesiastes 12, it says here, remember now your creator in the days of your youth, before the difficult days come and the years draw near when you say, I have no pleasure in them. While the sun and the light, the moon and the stars are not darkened, and the clouds do not return after the rain. In the day when the keepers of the house tremble and the strong men bow down, when the grinders cease because they are few, and those that look through the windows grow dim, when the doors are shut in the streets and the sounds of grinding is low.
Yes.
When one rises up at the sound of a bird and all the daughters of music are brought low. Also, they are afraid of heights and of terror in the way. When the almond tree blossoms, this grasshopper is a burden and desire fails. For a man goes to his eternal home, and the mourners go about the street. Hallelujah. Verse 6, it says, remember your creator before the silver cord is loosed, or the golden bowl is broken, or the pitcher shattered at the fountain, or the wheel broken at the well. Mighty God, this is here to tell us that as youth, we must remember our creator in the days of our youth, when we reach a stage that we can't do anything anymore. Hallelujah.
My God.
When the grinder sees we can't do nothing else, the we become old and feeble. We are of no use. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But I'm glad tonight the Solomon caught the vision and he's imploring us that we should remember the creator.
Remember.
In the days of our youth, before the difficult days come. We are seeing the difficult days now.
My God.
The difficult days are here. When we look around and when we hear what is happening all over the news. Mighty God. So many killings.
So many
diseases on top of diseases. I heard sisters, minister say the year have just started and over 10 persons have been killed in Canada. And it's not only in Canada, it's in America, it's in Jamaica, it's everywhere. People are losing their lives.
Mm-hmm. The
evil days are here. And the difficult days are here. And at that time, you're going to hear people say, me can't bother with God. Me not have no time for God because it not make no sense. It not help. But let me tell you, the only God is the only way out of this situation.
Only way out.
I'm encouraging a young person tonight to let them know that God is the only way out. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all its righteousness. And all other things will be added unto you. Seek him while he can be found. Call upon him while he is near.
Yes. Glory to God.
I'm imploring a young person, somebody here under the hearing of my voice this evening. Seek a friend before you need one.
Dear God, what a message.
Glory to God. If we see what is happening, now is the time to draw close to God.
My God, help us.
So many things are happening around us. We do not know if we're going to live to see tomorrow. We do not know what is going to happen. I'm here now. I did not know that I'm going to catch a COVID. My situation could have been worse.
So true.
Glory to God. So many catch it. and they're in so much pain.
And never recover.
Some persons never recover. Glory never. To God. Hallelujah. But tonight I am rejoicing in the God that I serve.
Yes.
In Jesus.
And I'm glad that I was seeking him a long time. I didn't wait until when I got sick. Glory to God.
Amen.
Mighty God. I was seeking him because I know that he was the only one who could have kept me and protect me in this time.
My God, God is awesome.
I'm a known asthmatic, and I can tell you I got this virus, and I don't have no sickness. I don't have no shortness of breath. I'm not sick.
You're covered.
Who could it be?
You're covered.
Jesus. Awesome.
Glory
awesome.
To God.
You are covered.
Yeah. I have rheumatoid arthritis, and they say, well, that's the worst arthritis. It's crippling. And they say, ache. I will have joint pain and aches and pain. Glory to God.
But God. But God.
But God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And when people see you as an adult standing up with God and the promise of God, we are the one that paved the way, that shined the light. That,
my
listen,
God.
We have been there. We have experienced God. We know exactly what we're talking about. This is not fairy tale, because we do have the rheumatoid arthritis, and then for this COVID, and we are still alive and not in pain. This got to be God.
Amen.
This got to be God. Young people,
and I'm saying, I did not take any vaccine. I did not take any vaccine, but I'm covered under the blood of Jesus.
I'll be covered, sister. Comprehensively covered.
Comprehensively covered.
Yes.
When my family and people are wondering, and they said to me, what is happening with you, knowing that you are so sickly and you have so many underlying sickness? I said, listen, my God is able. And I'm telling a young person this evening.
Yes.
That God is able to keep you.
God is able. Divine ability.
He's a young man's keeper. He's an old man keeper. He's a young girl keeper. He's woman keeper. Whatever stage you come to him, he will not turn you away.
My God.
His grace is sufficient to keep you.
Yes, it is.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Tonight I'm rejoicing in the God of my salvation.
Oh, praise God.
I am not worried. I have no fear.
No.
Because I know I'm covered under the blood of Almighty God.
Oh, bless God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
You too can come under this umbrella, under this coverage. This is comprehensive coverage.
Yes.
And you don't have to pay no insurance company for this coverage.
Come on now.
It is free. Full comprehensive coverage.
Yes. Paid for in full.
Paid for in full by the blood of Jesus Christ.
Blood.
My God.
Hallelujah.
When other people say, whose report
do you believe?
I'm not believing what other people say. I'm believing God, because I know he's able. And that's what I'm living under. When I said, listen, I had already placed the lintel, the blood upon the lintel of my heart.
Come on now.
So I know I'm covered under the blood of Jesus.
My God.
So I'm here to tell somebody this evening. I'm here to encourage a young person this evening. Mighty God. Remember the Creator.
Remember him.
Remember the Creator in the days of your youth. Don't wait until you can't do nothing. 6 and 7 person have to carry you. I have to lift you up to carry you. Go put you in the pool to get you baptized. My God. I'm not saying if you come at that time, he will not accept you. My God. But no, when you have the vigor and vitality and the vigor is in your body, Now is the time to serve God.
Yes, sir. My God.
Glory to God. Don't watch what others are doing. Don't watch what your friends are saying or what they are doing. Because listen, when trouble come and when sickness come, everybody gone. You alone left in it.
My God.
And it's only when you have a relationship with him, you can stand like how I'm standing today and say, I am not worried because I know I'm covered under the blood of Jesus.
My God, what a God.
That's the God I'm inviting you to. That's the God I'm encouraging somebody to come and taste and see that the Lord is good. God is so good. My God. And tonight I'm just giving God thanks. I'm just giving God thanks for his keeping care and his tender mercies.
Amen.
That God has been good to me. And I know he has been good to many, all of you, because you are still here.
Still here.
You are still here. It is nothing good that you have done while you are here. So many have passed and gone, not only with COVID, but other diseases, gunman, so many things happen, fire. Mighty God, it was yesterday or sometimes yesterday told me that a family, 2 sisters and 8 children got burnt out and all of them died in a fire.
Oh God.
We are still here. And it's a reason God has given us another chance to make our wrongs right and our crooked paths straight.
Jesus.
And I'm encouraging somebody this evening. If you have not yet tasted, come taste and see that the Lord is good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. At this time, we have Minister Siobhan is still on. And I know he always have a word. So I'm going to ask him to come and give an exhortation and to encourage somebody before we put on the man of God. Hallelujah.
And while he's getting ready to come, we want to welcome Bishop Sutton watching and Minister McCallman also watching. We have quite a few watching persons who are watching. Brother Maverick Daly, Sister Diane McPherson. We have Sister Karen Anderson, Brother Derek Hewitt, Missionary Sharon Forrester, Sister Carlin Dale, Atoy Smith, and all those who are watching on social media. Heaven bless you and welcome. Great to have you with us. All the ministering servants of God. Happy New Year to every one of you. Heaven bless you.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
And of course, Pastor Gregory Mitchell watching. Bless you.
Amen. Welcome, Pastor Gregory Mitchell and all. Welcome, my cousin. Glory to God. Minister Robbie McCallman. Hallelujah. Yes. Glory to God. And all Amen. The others who are watching. God bless you and welcome.
My good friend, Kim Taylor.
Praise God. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Amen. Go ahead, Minister. I hear you.
You know, you were speaking, Evangelist Shepherd, as you were speaking and saying we don't need to wait. We are now in 2022,
Amen.
A new year. This is the year that we need to be in Christ. We need to be in Christ with everything that is occurring. We see what's happening with the COVID. A lot of people have lost lives. We see Minister Sadie testified and she talked about the debt toll that is rising in Canada. And it's not only in Canada, it's all over the world. It's in Jamaica, it's all over the globe.
All over.
These are the times where we need to look up. We need to stay in Christ. We need to get in Christ. And you, we don't want to wait. You don't want to wait till something, till trouble is there. He is going to be your provider. He's going to be your protector. But
you need to
devote your time. You need to get into the Word. We need to stay in Christ. Because we want to hear, well done, good and faithful servant.
My
we don't
God.
Want to hear, we know you not. And
my
as
God.
The year is just starting, I know oftentimes we set New Year's resolution, right? Let that be one of your resolution to get into the Word, to get to know the Creator, to stay in Christ, to get the fullness. And let's not wait, because what's going to happen is when we wait till it's too late, you're going to say, if we didn't know, we start, or if we did this, let's not wait for that time. Let's not wait for it to be too late. Let us get into the Word. You, let this be your New Year's resolution. Your resolution is to devote your time to Christ.
Yes, sir.
To read daily.
Amen.
Start out with a 15-minute, 5 minutes. Open the Bible and get into the Word. And increase it as you go along. Increase it, because as you start getting older into it and the knowledge starts forming, you want to know more. Songwriter said, the more I walk with him, the sweeter he gets. The more I know him, the sweeter he gets.
Yes.
My
people,
God.
Right now as the world is, right, tomorrow is not promised. Tomorrow isn't promised. And I was telling Minister Sadie, my friend lost his son. He went to sleep and he never wake up.
Oh, God.
He lost 26 years old. A young adult.
Not yet seen life.
Right? So these are the trying times. And everything is fulfilling. And we should get into the Word. So young people, I'm encouraging you tonight to get into the Word. Get in, know the Creator, know him for yourself, right? Know him on a personal level, have that connection. You cannot depend on anyone but yourself. Get connected to him. It's 2022, and as we know, it was just the other day, we're in 2021. The days, it is numbered, and the days are going fast, and we know it's as redemption draw nigh. When we see, look up, these are the times.
My God.
And our friends can't save us.
No
your
friends.
Your co-worker, parents can't save you. Your sister can't save you. Your aunt or uncle can't save you. Only Christ can. And the only way you can get in and know him is opening up the Word and get into it. Dedication. Devote your time. Start out first thing in the morning and get to know him. Get an understanding.
Yes.
Get an understanding. Connect with him. Know him on a personal level.
My God,
have a relationship.
You will have your testimony, a relationship, and you will have a testimony. And he is your provider. He is your way maker. He makes a way when all seems impossible and all seems dark. And you hear the ministers tell you that it doesn't matter. He will provide for you. He will keep you. Talk to him. Create, open that line with him. And don't be dependent on nobody else. Friends are not going to save you. The video games can't save you. Social media can't save you.
Come on now.
Nothing.
My God.
Nothing. So take 5 minutes out. Take 5 minutes and open up the Bible. Read a scripture. Get that understanding. And you can't say you didn't know. We are given ample warning. We're getting that warning out, and we're calling you, because the Holy Spirit is calling. The Holy Spirit wants And he knows. So let us hold fast and let us get into the word. Let us connect with him for 2022. Read, speak to him, young people, whatever situation you have. Minister, mention it. You can. When your friends can't keep that secret, Christ can keep it because he already knows what is happening. So spend time with him. When you're in the shower, when you're anywhere, when you're by yourself, talk to him. He's there. His word said he'll never leave you nor forsake you. And
glory to God.
When you get connected to him, have a conversation with him. Have a con. And I'm telling you, if you listen, he's
have
answering
a
you.
Talk with
he's
Jesus,
leading
man,
you.
Makes it right.
He is leading you. But when you're too busy with the cares of the world, you miss the communication that he's having with you. So sometimes you just have to be still and listen. Listen. Open up that line of communication and listen. Speak to him. Whatever is troubling you, whatever it is, he already knows, but he wants to hear it from you. He wants you to trust him. And if you're not talking to him, and you're talking to someone else, you're talking to flesh, flesh can't help you. Speak to God. God is the only one that is able. So for 2020, I'm encouraging the youth to stay in Christ. This is the year to get into Christ. Open up that line of communication. Give him that devotion, that time. Give him that time. End that social media and spend time in his word and with him. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, my sister.
God bless you. God bless you, man of God, for those words of encouragement. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Listen, this is a time to spend time. The songwriter said, have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our struggles. He will hear our faintest cry and he will answer by and by. Just have a little talk with Jesus and make it right. Glory to God. I'm imploring someone here tonight. Spend time with the Lord. Now it's 2022. We can't continue the way we did in 2021. We have to make a new start. Spend more time with the Lord. Give him more of your time. So many times we spend time with our friends. We spend time on the phone. We spend time watching television. And God get the less or the least of our time. It is a new year. I'm not going to tell anybody to make any resolution, but I am imploring you, I'm encouraging you to spend some more time with the Lord, spend some more time in the Word. It doesn't matter what age you are. Spend a little time with Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. At this time, glory to God, I'm going to ask again, Sister Joy, to sing for us before the man of God comes with the word. Hallelujah, glory. Hold on. Okay, I just want to, before Sister Joy comes, I just want to make welcome to Sister Debbie, Pastor Debbie. Oh, Pastor Debbie Steadman, she's here with us. And I just want to say a warm welcome to Pastor Debbie Steadman. I heard she's not feeling well, but glory to God. I know that the healing power of Almighty God will, wherever she is at this time, hallelujah, will reach her. And whatever situation she's faced with, she will be made whole. In Jesus' name, glory to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Years I spent in vanity and pride came not my Lord was crucified. Knowing not it was for me, he died on Calvary. Oh yes, mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied for me. Oh there, my burden soul found liberty at Calvary. Oh yes, now I give to Jesus everything. Now I gladly hold him as my king. Now my raptured soul can only sing of Calvary. Come on, sing now,
mercy was great and grace was free.
Oh, pardon
there was deep
to me. I said there, my burden soul found me, Bertie.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yes, mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. I said, there my burden soul found liberty at Calvary. Oh, now by sin must grace and sin I learn. Now I tremble at the low aspen. Now my guilty soul in glory turn to Calvary. I said mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary. One more time. I said mercy there was great and grace was free.
Pardon
there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God. Mighty God. The songwriter is reminding us tonight, glory to God. Glory to God, that we can be liberated from sin.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Mighty God. We don't have to walk that road anymore, because it was there our burden soul found liberty
on
Calvary. He says, pardon there was multiplied to us.
Yes.
My God. He said, grace was there and grace was free.
Was free, free, free.
Free.
Yes.
Amen.
Grace free. Is free tonight.
Yes.
And pardon there. So listen, no matter what you have done tonight, I'm encouraging a young person here tonight. Pardon is there.
Multiplied
to you.
So yes. No matter what situation you find yourself in, no matter how far you think you're gone.
I'm gone.
Pardon there was multiplied. Grace was free. All on Calvary.
Yes.
My God. God bless you, woman of God, for that powerful song. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And at this time, glory to God, before, without any further ado, glory to God, I just put on the man of God. Glory to God. He will come and do whatever the Lord would have him to do tonight. Glory to your name.
Glory to your name.
To God be the praise and the glory and the honor. Amen. I give the Lord praise for all that he has done, what he's doing, and the mighty plans that he has for our lives.
My God.
The prophet Jeremiah, the plans I have for you are plans to do you good and not evil, and to give you a wonderful end. I want to thank God for that wonderful song. Mercy there was great, and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied for me. There my burdened soul for liberty.
Oh, liberty.
Calvary. And I can tell you that, amen, 43, almost 40 years ago, when I was just step out of my teenager years, that as a young man, I found the man Jesus. As a matter of fact, he found me, because I was the one who was lost. I was lost, not knowing what direction to turn, where to go. But thank God, he came right on time. Not that I first loved God, but that he first loved me.
And amen.
My salvation. I want to thank our audience tonight in the studio with me, Evangelist Shepherd, Minister Sadie Campbell, Sister Vivian Nicholson, praise God, Pastor Debbie, amen with us, and of course, Minister Chevron, and the wonderful, wonderful viewers and listeners, including ministers of the gospel, bishops and evangelists and pastors, according to your rank. God bless you. So happy for you to join in with us tonight, and I pray that you will be blessed.
Amen.
Let me go quickly to the word of God, and the first youth meeting for year 2022. My God, I never thought I would have lived to see this year 2022, but God has been good. Isn't that good?
Amen.
God is good. Let me also greet Lady Tammy Marrett. God bless you watching. Good to see you. Amen. Lady Marrett, God bless your heart. All right, the book of Psalm 119, verse 9. And it says, wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed thereto according to thy word. With my whole heart have I sought thee, or let me not wander from thy commandment. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. With my lips have I declared all the judgments of thy mouth. I have rejoiced in the way of thy testimonies as much as in all riches. And that is coming from the word of a young man who was just a shepherd boy. But amen. There was something particular about David as a youngster. And this proves beyond a shadow of a doubt that youngsters, regardless of the country or culture or tribe you are from, there's a God part of you that no devil can't touch, no devil can't move. When you decide to love God and to follow God, there's something that God will come by you, God will walk with you, he will guide you, direct your path. Even when gang members will try to say, come, take this gun or sell this drugs, the God in you will not allow that. You can be that I refuse to follow the bad example. I refuse to go down the wrong road. There's a God that I must serve, a God I must follow. And I want to thank God publicly on this broadcast for every young person across the world who have chosen to follow Jesus Christ. You have been tempted. You have been tested. You have been tried. You have been mocked. You have been laughed at. As Sister Vivian said, she was laughed at. But thank God she's still here. She's amen. Still proving that God is still a young girl keeper. He's still a young boy keeper. And that once your hand and your life is in the hand of God, you don't have to fall down to drugs anymore or sexual promiscuity. You don't have to fall down and become a gambler, a gunman, a young murderer. Look at so many young people who are in jail tonight. Some are in hospital because of drugs and other related offenses. But thank God, young people across the world who have embraced your salvation, embraced your God, loving Jesus. You'd be surprised to know that there are so many young people across the world that truly, truly love Jesus Christ. I can remember some years ago, I was at Hampton High School when I stood to minister in their chapel service. And there were so many young ladies who were born again believers who have decided to follow Jesus Christ. And they went through high school untouched because they made up their mind to follow Jesus. I've been to Manuel College at their chapel service, an all boys school. And I've seen young men who have stood up for God. Even until today, they're still serving God. So there are young people across the world that you cannot do anything to pull them away from God. They will say, my mind is made up and I can't do that. And there are young people tonight that God can count on. Even in countries where the laws and the rules of the country forbid them to seek after God. But there's a way that God will find that it will always get to the heart of young men and young women. And there's nothing that demons or devil or man-made institution cannot change their mind. But here we have this young man, David, all by himself in the wilderness with his father's sheep. He found time to spend with God and in the Word. How do you, Pastor, how do you know that he spent time in the Word? When you read this verse here, verse 10 says, wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? And when you can find young men, young women, have a desire to walk clean, to walk upright, not to become stained or blemished or contaminated by the things of this life, to remain pure. And I tell you something, it is good when young men, young women can remain pure, because you don't know, God may send a man, a young man or a young woman in your life, and you're looking to find such a person to become your wife, to become your life partner, somebody you can trust, you can depend on, you can lean on. So it is important to remain clean. Young people, you can remain clean. Middle-aged people, you can remain clean. Aged men, aged women, you also can remain clean. It is expected of us to remain clean. So don't think that it's just for the young people we're talking about tonight. Because there's some older people who act young, who need to get back to basics too. But here we find the Holy Spirit put in the Word. He said, wherewithal, where shall a young man cleanse his ways? But by taking heed to the Word of God. And I guarantee you that any one of us, as a child of God, decide and determine to follow Jesus. Amen. In this time and in this country and society, it takes much God in you to stand up for God. One of my favorite Bible characters is a young man by the name of Enoch. He started serving God at a tender age. In those days, when people live up to 900 years, 800 years, 700 years, this young man started to serve God at the age of 65 years old. 65! In those days, that would be tantamount to about 11, 12, 13, maybe up to 15 years old in comparison to today's age factor. And so this young man at 65, in his time, started to serve God. And he followed God for 300 unbroken years. There's some people coming to the church, and after 1 year, 1 month, 1 week,
my God, they get fed up on God.
They can't remain. This young man, Minister Shepherd, he had no pastor, he had no church, he had no deacon, he had no exhorter, he had nobody to encourage him. Nobody. He found God to be true. He found God to be a foundation. He found God to be a solid rock. And can you imagine, listeners and ministers, that when 100 years pass, and don't think that during his time there was not evil. There was evil and wickedness. There were giants in the land, corruption in the land, bloodshed in the land. There was no police, no lockup, no soldier. And everybody did that which was right in their own eyes. So he lived at a time when it was vicious on the planet. demons roam loose. But
my God, my God, come on, preacher. Come on.
This young man decided for the first 50 years, he said, I found a friend in Jesus. He's everything to me. You see, the modern day, because Jesus did not appear to him then. But there was something about this young man. And God began to set his eyes on Enoch. And when 100 years passed, the young man still continued to
flow
in his walk with God. Determined not to be a drunkard. Determined not to join the gang. Determined not to be a rapist. Determined not to follow the trend of the then day. And when 150 years passed, he was still committed.
My God, you could my not God.
Move him. And I believe if he knew this scripture, he would say to you, what shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me? And how can I keep myself? Listen, when he saw this, the lifestyle around him, he must have become angry, upset. But further, he was determined. He was committed. Young people across the world, I'm saying to you, and all of men and women and ministers of the cloth, amen, be determined to stand up for God wherever you are planted, wherever God placed you. No
retreat,
no surrender, no giving in, and no giving up. There's
come on, preacher, come on.
Placing you. There's a God, part of God in you. When God breathed into man's nostril and he kept a living soul, the God factor, the God factor in you, wanting to please God, wanting to serve God, want the best for God. There's a joy in you when you can serve God and serve God right. There's a joy you will never experience the life is right with God. Young people, see to it in your life that your ways, your heart, and your spirit will seek to please God. You don't have to follow the realm and the kingdom of darkness. There's better on the side of the light. There's greater praise and glory when you put your life in the hand of God.
My God.
Can you imagine Minister Sadie Campbell? After 200 years, there's not one of us on this program who will live to see 200 years. Not one will say maybe 100.
Not anymore. No way.
But sin. That young man, oh God Almighty, that young man, a matter of fact, in those days, my listeners, when you reach 150, you're considered a child. You could not get married. You could, as a female, you could not get pregnant. You're too young. You check the Bible history if you don't believe me. So when you reach 150, when you reach 200, you are still a child. And that determination, Minister Chevron, was still there for him to hold on to God.
Glory to God.
Mr. Nicholson, did something about this man, Enoch, and God said, hold on. I believe that God said, hold on. God sat on his throne and he said, come here, Jesus. Come here, Michael. Come here, Gabriel.
Come on.
Down on earth. There's a man on the planet. Look. His light is shining. There's grace on his life. His love far outshine the brightest star. God could not help but notice that there was a young man on the planet. And Jesus said, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and be led to glorify your Father in heaven.
God
for the young people who have stayed out of trouble, who refused to break the man's shop, who refuse to break the supermarket, who refuse to steal that Nike shoes, or to steal that expensive jacket, or to steal that expensive handbag. There's something about the fear of God in our young people that, my God, you can trust them. Oh, hallelujah. Somebody praise God.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Listen, not every young person. Not every young person, Minister Shepherd, will steal. Not every young person will fierce with you. Not every young person ready to fight you and to kick you down. There are young persons out there who will love you. Listen, there are some young people that love the older ones and they care for you. They'll watch out for you. They'll stand up for you. My God, they exercise some qualities that we long to see around us because God have his hand on them. And when God this young man. I believe that God said to the court of heaven, you know, if he not continue for another year, I'm gonna surprise him.
My God,
bring him to heaven. Not just
my God. For
a 2 week vacation or a 1 month vacation. Oh my. How many persons God ever give a vacation who work for God and live for God?
That my God.
That God has something wonderful for all those who will fight the good fight. Who refuse to mess up their garment. There's still a few in Sardis. Not just old people, but young people who refuse to soil their garden. There's some young ladies, you can't tempt them with your money. You can't pull them away with your flashy car and your diamond and your gold necklace. And you can't fool them with your apartment. They refuse to sell out. You can't buy them. But they will tell you, I'm already the price. The blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. Somebody bless God in this place.
Hold out, man. Hold out.
I'm trying not to preach. But, oh, God, there's something here. Listen, Minister Sadie, when God looked down on the earth, can you imagine how God must have felt to see somebody, a young man, all by himself, no other young person of his age or of his group wanted to follow God? Can you imagine how they must have tormented him, mocked him, jeered him, slander him, and called him weak, and called him he's not a man, and they must have labeled him, but he was so determined. He was fixed.
And I made up mine to serve
my
God.
My heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. Oh, thank God for young people tonight on this program whose heart is fixed in God. Hallelujah. Yes. Not all young men will walk out of the way. Not all of them you can inveigle to do evil at the risk of their life. They have stood the test. Oh, yes, some have been beaten and beaten bad by gang members, but yet they refuse to serve the devil and his team, and they stood up for God. And you know, the more I look at the story with this young man and his God, a young man and his God, Sister Vivian, you could label this tonight, a young man and his God.
Amen.
And you go further in the book of Daniel chapter 1, you can say, the young men and their God, with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, refusing to be pulled down by their God. He says, we don't want to eat the meat that is offered to idols. We might be young, but we have values. We may be young.
We will not bow.
Integrity. We might be young, but we know there's only one true and living God. There was something. Yes. Oh, hallelujah. Young men and their God. A young man and his God. But it's a pastor, what about the ladies? Oh, yes. There was a young lady and her God. Hallelujah. Named Sister Esther. She refused to mess up with the rest. And God kept her. And she had no idea that she was being brought along the way by God to become the wife of a king, to be taken from nowhere. Oh, when you keep yourself clean, when you keep yourself pure.
Perish.
Mary, Elizabeth.
You don't know the plan.
Women who stood up.
Oh, praise God. You don't know the plan that God has for you. When you keep yourself clean, keep yourself pure. Not everybody can spot you like when you go to the marketplace and buy breadfruit or buy some fruit. Amen. You're untouchable. You belong to God. And you know, listen, they will call your name. They say you're proud. They say you're boasty. And some will tell you, you act as if you're better than anybody else. No. But you know that you are bought with a price.
Peculiar, man. You're special.
In the sight of God. And the wise man Solomon, he said, who can find a virtuous woman? Her price is far above rubies. Young ladies watching and listening, you are valuable. You are priceless. When men look at you, let them respect you.
Yes.
Let them, listen, let them work to get you. Don't be easy. No run on marriage. Let the men run you down and value you. Listen, you need to know your value.
Yes.
Know your value. You are not bronze. You are not silver. You are gold.
Oh,
and you can up your value by saying, I am a diamond.
My God.
You got to dig deeper. Search longer to find a diamond. And that's who you are to be. Priceless. Hallelujah. Yes. This young man and his God, in a time when no church, no Bible, not operating, and when God said, when 250 years were expired, God said, all right, let me draw closer. He said, Jesus, let me draw closer. Michael, what do you think? And they all agreed. The council of heaven agreed. So we want this man in heaven. We want him up here. Oh, God Almighty. Listen, if you only know how much God can't wait to take us in the rapture to glory, that no sin anymore cannot touch you. No devil can't mess you up.
Glory to God.
Rock your body. God has a wonderful plan for everyone that belongs to him. And when 280 years, amen, God said, listen, I'm just in God's time, a few minutes, and her time, 20 more years to come. And the man did not know. And the Bible said, Enoch walked with God. Hallelujah. Never.
Yes, Jesus.
And thank God tonight, there are young people. All the people, me, yes, people are walking with God. I'm not saying that the going has been easy. The going has been nice. But there's something on the inside that propels you, that motivates you, that stirs you up, that keeps you going in good times and in bad times. And especially in COVID, when the job not working and money not flowing. But God's grace has kept you that you wouldn't let go. We are here today.
Yes, Lord.
God's grace. Oh, hallelujah. Thank God for those tonight who seek to keep clean. Somebody say, clean. Keep me clean.
Clean. Clean.
Oh, hallelujah. It's not just a word because I ask you to say it, but it's a cry from your heart to keep me clean in a dirty world, a mixed up world, a contaminated world, a world of unbelievers,
a world of liars,
a world of gamblers, a world of men and women seeking for power, political power, tribalism, war on every side, earthquake, snowstorm, tornado, and all kind of thing is there to push away from God. But when you have found the master and decide, I'm going to live clean, I'm going to live right, I'm going to dress right, I'm going to sound right, I'm going to be right for my God. I am bought with a price. I'm a child of God. Can somebody bless God in the house tonight?
Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I'm trying not to preach, really. I'm trying not to preach. I'm fighting not to preach. But I'm feeling good in my spirit.
Hallelujah. Mighty God, hallelujah.
And the Bible says, amen, as the time drew near, 200, sister said it, maybe I'm the oldest one on the platform right now. But can you imagine a man serving God for 299 years, 11 months, not knowing that you only have one more month, and heaven's stamping visa approved by heaven, approved by angel. Listen, there was no spacecraft. No space rocket. Hallelujah. But God has a way to rescue those whom he loves.
My God.
That's why God said to Jeremiah, the plans I have for you. Hear me, young people. God have a plan for your future, for your destiny. Mm-hmm.
Glory to God.
You don't know where God wants to take you. Uh-huh. You don't know what your tomorrow will bring. Joseph had a dream as a young boy way back in Palestine, but God had another country to exalt him, to promote him. I cannot tell you, if you wait on God a little bit longer, young people, you don't have to run down nothing. Just wait on God. The Bible says promotion come not from the east, not from the west. Promotion come from God. And if you hold on a little bit longer, just as how God promote, amen, Enoch, in the Old Testament, early in the book of Genesis, when just the last month left, 299 years, 11 months, 3 weeks, 1 week left, God had a surprise for the young man. Oh, God Almighty.
My God.
He was now 365 years old. And when the last hour left, God said, angel, prepare the chariot. This same chariot of fire that carried Elijah to glory. Listen, outer space can't touch you when God cover you.
My God, my God.
No stone particle can't touch you. When you leave Earth atmosphere into the ionosphere and the stratosphere and all the other sphere, because God who made the world, he knows exactly how to keep you safe. And I'm saying to young people tonight that God can keep you safe.
Yes. Amen.
God wants to watch over you. And if you put your life in the hand of God, look at the ending of this young man called Enoch. When the time came, the Bible said God took him. Enoch was translated. And listen, he never tasted death. Death could, God preserved this young man. God watched over him. Sister Vivian, this is a miracle. This is a God-blessed miracle. Young people, God have a miracle with your name on it.
My God, come on.
It is a blessing await you if you decide to keep clean. David found the secret. I'm going to give it to you tonight. Wherewithal should a young man, a young woman cleanse his and her way?
Taking heed.
Taking heed. Pay attention. Apply the word. If the word says holiness, is holiness. If the word says speak truth, speak truth. The Lord said give up bitterness and anger, give it up. And love God, serve God, walk with God. You cannot go wrong when you put God first. Hallelujah. Listen, Bertrand, listen to me. I'm going to turn over back in a short while, but listen. I would love to interview, Jesus, Sister Evangelist Shepherd. I would love to interview Enoch. How did you feel while growing up? What did it feel like? Did you see earth while growing up? And was the speed so fast in a moment, in the twinkle of an eye? What kind of food are you eating up there? Do they have bathroom? Are you walking on gold? Are you in the streets of glory? Have you drunk from the fountain of living water from the throne of God? Tell me something, Brother Enoch. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Saints of God, young people, when you get there, there'll be no dying there. No hospital. No COVID. No sadness. No blood pressure. No stress. No hypertension. Talk to me, somebody. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Serve God. Serve God. God bless you. Back over to our co-host, Evangelist Shepherd, in Jesus' name.
Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on. Man of God, I thought you was going to continue, man. What a word. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a word. Those are some of the questions, hallelujah, we'd really want to ask Enoch.
My God.
Is he walking on streets of gold?
Has the clothes changed? But they went up in. Eating angel food.
Mike, if it's just milk and honey, he's up there having.
And you know, the thing about Enoch being in heaven is that he has not grown older. He's the same age today as when he left Earth 5,000 years ago. How is that possible? Because he is not living in Earth time. He's living in eternity. So he has not aged. He's still the same Enoch, just the way he left here. Elijah has not aged any further either. Two men that God took up to heaven, and that tells us that the rapture is real. The catching away of the saints is real.
My God. I'm waiting, Lord.
One bright morning.
I'm waiting.
One glorious day. We shall be changed. In a moment.
In the twinkling of an eye.
At the last trump. For the trumpet of God shall sound. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. We who are alive and remain shall be caught up together.
Caught up to meet him in the air.
Oh, glory. Young people will be there, even babies and children will be there. And the sad fact is, some young people will be in heaven, but mommy won't be there, papa won't be there, grandpa won't be there. Some friends won't be there. Some classmates won't be there because they did not take heed to keep themselves clean to be approved of God.
Glory to God.
Parents who are listening, if your child is a Christian, encourage them. And Sister Bibi said,
encourage
listen.
Them, encourage
if
them.
Your young son or daughter want to follow Jesus in water baptism, do not hold them back. The young children of today, they're bound with sense. They know right from wrong.
Tell it.
My God.
Amen.
Tell it.
We've seen some people dress up their children like Halloween stuff to follow demonic order. Huh? Bring them to the church.
Bring them
to the house of God.
My God.
To them. Read the Bible to them. Pray over them.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Teach them the will of God. Teach them about God.
Yes.
My God.
Yes. Jesus. Over glory to you, Evangelist Shepherd.
Thank you. Thank you, man of God. Thank you, Pastor Steadman, for that powerful word. Hallelujah. Mighty God, each and every one of us that is listening tonight, we have received a word and we anticipate, glory to God, that great getting up morning, whatever time it's going to be, when glory to God, we will all caught up to meet him in the air. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise Hallelujah. God. Glory to God. Enoch did not know.
It's a surprise.
Glory to God.
It's a surprise.
Neither did Elijah know.
What a surprise. Jesus.
My God. But they walked with the Lord. The Bible says Enoch walked with the Lord.
Yes.
Glory to God. Elijah wrestled with the angel.
And Jacob wrestled.
Jacob wrestled with the angel.
Not letting you go till you bless me.
I will not let you go until you bless me. So this is what we ought to do. Hold on, because we do not know. Glory to God. Elisha, they were walking and they were going across. And Elisha said to Elijah, so give me a double portion.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, if you see me.
You receive it.
If you see me when I'm going up, you will receive.
Yes.
Glory to God. And listen, Elijah did not take his eyes off him. Because he wanted a double portion. He was determined.
My God.
To get a double portion of the blessing.
We must remain determined. No matter what.
We must remain determined. We can't be distracted. So many persons try to distract Elisha.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. They're trying.
So many persons that discourage him, and he say, "Hold your peace."
Oh, God.
Hold your peace.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want no distraction because what my eyes is on the prize.
My God.
Glory to God. No matter what is happening around you. There might be a bird whispering in your ears, telling you things, but tell him, hold the peace.
Yes, man.
Hold your peace because my eyes is on the prize. I have to get a double portion. I want some of what Elijah have.
My God.
I can't be comfortable in the same old situation.
My God, there must be a change.
There must be a change. And glory to God with determination,
mm-hmm.
He was endued with power. Glory to God, because he keep his eyes on the man of God. I'm here to encourage a young person tonight. Keep your eyes on the prize. Don't be distracted.
Jesus.
Don't allow the naysayers.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them will tell you, say, as somebody you see in a church, make you gone in there.
My God.
So they say, who you are, follow. Mm-hmm. And then we give you 9 days. Some of them will give you three months, 1 year.
Mighty God.
But keep your eyes on the prize.
Keep your eyes.
Keep your eyes on the prize.
Yes.
You do not know what the Lord have in store. Glory to God.
There's treasure.
Job was one of them. He could have listened to his friends. He could have listened to his wife, but he said, no. You talk like one of those foolish women. When his friend came and when he said all those things, he prayed for them, even in his situation. Listen, when people say bad things about you, pray for them.
Yes.
Because what? You know that your eyes is on the prize. You know that God knows your name and God can boast about you. Mm-hmm. He can say, have you considered my servant, Sandra? Have you considered my servant, Sadie? Have you considered my servant, Joy? Have you considered my servant, Eric? Have you considered my servant, Siobhan? Have you considered my servant, Debbie? Glory to God. Keep your eyes on the prize.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be distracted. No matter what is happening around you, keep your eyes on the prize. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. At this time, I know Pastor Debbie is here. I don't know if she just want to just come and just greet before we leave, because we're about to close now before we pray. I don't know if she just want to come and greet. Glory to God. Okay.
Good night. Good night. Good night, everyone. Good night.
Good night.
God bless you, woman of God. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah.
Good night, Pastor Debbie.
Good night, Sister Sadie, Pastor Steadman, and Evangelist Shepherd. Praise God. I am so happy. Sorry for you not seeing my face. I know Sister
Sadie
okay,
wants sis.
To see my face, but I am not feeling too well, and my daughter and my son, they're not feeling well either, and we're just trying to keep it as it is, and trust in God, continue to
Amen.
Pray and trust God, because with God all things are possible, and I strongly believe that the God that I serve, the God that we all serve,
Amen.
Is a never failing God. He will never fail none of us. And Amen. He is our healer. He is our miracle worker. He is our promise keeper. And even though we cannot see him just like we are looking at each other, but he is there. The important Amen. Thing is that he is there and he hears and he answers and he sees our tears. You see, when we cry, he see everything. He understands yes. and he knows. The songman said, tears are a language
yes,
that
Lord.
God understands. Sometimes the words cannot come out of our mouth. And sometimes all we have to do is just shed the tears. Or sometimes we just have to just groan in the spirit. And God understands everything mm-hmm. about us. He understands. So I'm asking you tonight just to remember me and my children in prayer. We need your prayer at this time. We need God's divine intervention. We need the healing hand of God to rest upon us, and that the Lord will just see us through. Not so long ago, my daughter was breathing a bit heavy. She was breathing very fast, and I had to you know, get the water, the hot water and the mental crystal, and let she steam her face. And thanks be to God, her breathing is a bit better. I know the enemy just trying, the enemy's trying, because we're living in a trial sometime. And the enemy is trying to do everything in his power to distract us and to take our focus off the Lord, off the cross. But as Sister Shepherd was saying, that this is a time for us not to take our mind off or our focus, and nothing is going to stop her from getting where she wants to get. Amen. And this should be all of us as believers. All of us desire and intention is to get what we want to get, and nothing should stop us from getting where we want to get in God. We should all have that kind of determination. And it brings me back to, I remember when Pastor Steadman, when I was young, and Pastor Steadman, I was so determined, very, very determined. And I remember these words that he said to me, "Boy, Sister Debbie, the way in which how you determined and strong-headed, if you decide to sell out yourself to God, nothing," and when I said nothing, "can stop you from reaching heaven or to reach the goal that you set in God." And I truly believe that. I know I am very determined. And whatever I made up my mind to do, you know, as long as it is something good. I'm not talking about the bad things that I used to do. I'm talking about God now, because
serving
all things
God.
Are past away.
Serving yes. God and doing exploits for God.
Amen. So when I make up my mind and I said I am going, and I have set this goal in God, and I need to reach this goal in yes. God, and nothing by any means is going to stop me from reaching there. Let me tell you something. It doesn't make sense to come after me and tell me to change my mind, because a song man say, "I am determined to hold on to the end. Jesus is with me, and him I can depend. I am not depending on men. I am not depending on family. I am not depending on friends. I am depending on Jesus, and I know that he is going to see me through." God bless you tonight. Continue to pray for me and pray for my strength as I continue to worship the Lord, because my intention and my determination is to see Jesus someday, and whatever it takes for me to see him, I am going to push my way through. Like the woman with the issue of blood, I'm going to push my way through until I see my King. God bless you tonight. God bless you.
God bless you, woman of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know if there's any more prayer requests. I thought I saw Sister Maureen Simit right early in the somebody wrote earlier that they need prayer. Glory to God. And Pastor Debbie now, and even myself and her family and all the others that are in need. We are in need of prayer. Glory to God. Because we need the hands of the Lord to touch and to heal and deliver us. Glory to Amen. God. So at this time, glory to God, I'm going to ask Pastor Steadman to pray the closing prayer, and to pray for each and everyone who is not feeling well, who is in need of prayer. Glory to God.
But before we close off in prayer, Minister Sadie, have her part to do before we close up.
No, we were going to close. We're going to pray, and then we're going to just tell everybody thanks, and then she would get the final before we
okay.
go.
All right. Let us pray. Our gracious God, our Father, in the name of Jesus, the name above every other name, name of which every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. For you're far above all principality and power. You made a show of them open, and you triumph over the devil.
by the victory at the cross. And so, Father, we come before you because there's no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. And at the name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, every demon must bow at the authority and power of your name. Sickness and disease got to go, for there's such
enormous
power in that name. And Lord, I bring before you, amen, Evangelist Sandra Shepherd. I bring before you Pastor Debbie and her family. And what's the other person?
I think it was Sister Maureen Smith. I think I saw her right.
Sister Maureen Smith, Lord, and all those online, those are watching and listening, my God, with some kind of infirmity or sickness in their body or some disease, whether by natural causes or by heredity. We come against it in the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Arise
our majesty. You was wounded for our transgression.
Glory to God.
Iniquities and the chastisement of our peace was upon you, and by your stripes you are healed. I speak the life of God and the breath of the Holy Ghost upon every
soul. Yes,
tonight, my God, I look to you tonight for the healing touch of the Master's hand. The same Holy Ghost that raised Christ from the dead, even now quicken the mortal body. I command the bodies to be in alignment with the Word of God, even now.
Yes,
and
Lord.
Jesus said, "Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee." In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and be healed. In the name
Lord.
Of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
God, even right now, I command the body to be well. I come against sickness from whatever sort. Lord, touch your heart. Touch your liver. My God, touch your kidney. My God, the red blood cell, the white blood cell, the muscles, the joints, the tissues, the neck, the throat, the chest, the neck, back, the head. My God, the foot, the veins. Oh, God, let nothing left. Amen. That is not touched by the hand of God. Lord, we pray for a comprehensive miracle right now in the name of Jesus. Touch Minister Sadie likewise. My God, she was not feeling well the other day. And I pray, God, to minister to her
in the
name of Jesus Christ. You said, God, the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise them up. No, God, we look to you for the raising up. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh even now upon
my
the
God.
People. Of the bless you by the touch of the living God. Be
yes,
made
Lord.
Whole. Be made whole in Jesus' mighty name. What we bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. What we loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. Upon the authority and power of your word, we command it done in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, apply the need. Open doors in their life. Oh, God, cover them. Lord, be there for them in their good time and their bad time. Let the light of God shine upon their homes, upon their family. Scatter darkness left, right, and center.
My God. Light, hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah.
Over your children everywhere. Supply that need. The bills to be paid. Open those doors. You're promising your word. I will open that door and no man shut, and I shut a door and no man open. He said, "Behold, I lay before thee an open door." Divine God, I look to you tonight. Let you bless your people, make them the head and not the tail. Bless them in their going out and they're coming in. They're not sitting and they're uprising. I magnify you. I bless you. I give the praise.
Yes, Lord.
Living God, even now, in the name of Jesus, we pray, Lord, for every soul on the line tonight, from the ministers, the saints, the youngsters, young children, young adults, my God, at a crossroad tonight, at the crossroad of life, oh God, meet them, Lord, and minister to them in the name of Jesus. We pray for every soul across the world, in Jamaica, in the States, in Canada, in England, my God, in Europe, in the Middle East, in the Orient, in Africa, wherever they are watching this broadcast. Oh God, minister your word and touch them, God. And all those who, my God, who have ministered on the line tonight, my God, in song, in word, in exaltation, and other means and ways, those who make comments, solid godly comments. Oh God, bless them, Father, in the name of Jesus. We worship you and we thank you for what you have done tonight, Lord. Glorify yourself tonight. Magnify you, give a praise and glory. Thank you again, Lord, for the healing and for the children who sang tonight. and read the Bible. My God, with the Tiana and
Isaac.
I don't remember the name.
Isaiah and Tiana
and Tia. Lord, bless, oh Lord, look at children that you have blessed to be on this program. Lord, we pray that you'll send some more young people to be on the program to stand up for Jesus, not be afraid or ashamed or embarrassed, to stand up for the living God. Thank you, Lord, for Sister Vivia who sung and bless us. Thank you for Minister Siobhan and his children. Lord, keep your hand upon them. No evil shall come nigh their dwelling. Oh God, they shall not be hurt, neither by water or by fire or by accident or by knife or by gun. Watch over them, Holy Ghost of God. Watch over your children. Watch over the body of Christ and send revival. Send revival in every church and the
my God, of the my choir. God, hallelujah.
Oh, great God, we pray for healing for those who are afflicted with the COVID outside of salvation, who don't know you, Lord. And I pray, Lord, in their suffering, they find Jesus. They cry out to the Lamb of God. I thank you for your great salvation. For those who have strengthened themselves in their faith to walk like Enoch tonight, God, we pray you minister to them, strengthen the body of Christ, and they worship you, bless you, and give you all the praise in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody say amen.
Amen, amen, amen.
Glory
Sister Natalie Bartlett requests prayer for herself and her children and co-worker. Glory to God.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Natalie Bartlett.
Yes.
And her children and co-worker. Father, we bring this request before you. You say, God, we can come boldly to the throne of grace. We can make our request and petition be made known unto God. Lord, I bring this lady before you and her children, Lord, whom you know, made in your image and in your likeness, so they are not a stranger to God. The breath of God is in them, and the blood that you put in their veins and their heart that pump the blood. You know them, God. You know the distress. You know the setback and the limitation. How much they need the touch of God in their lives. I commit them in your hand even now. And I thank you for the supernatural touch of God, the miracle of the Most High. Holy Spirit of God, minister to them. Be healed. Be delivered tonight, this very hour. Let the warmth of your presence, my God, locate them even now with a right now miracle in Jesus' name. I give her the praise for the touch of God. Somebody give him praise.
Glory hallelujah. To God. Hallelujah. Thank hallelujah. You. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Tonight, I just want to say a big thank you. Glory to God. To each and everyone that made this program a success. Glory to God. To our host, Pastor Steadman, for granting us this privilege where we can come time after time to encourage youths across the globe. Glory to God. And glory to God to Sister Jory Nicholson. Glory to God. Minister Siobhan McClyman, Little Isaiah, Little Taya, and Little Tayana. Sister Pastor Debbie, glory to God. Minister Sadie Campbell, glory to God. And all these wonderful saints watching on Facebook and on the YouTube channel, glory to God, and whatever platform, glory to God, my cousin Minister Robbie McCallman, glory to God, Sister Claudette Duffus, Pastor Gregory Steadman, Gregory Mitchell, sorry about that, Pastor Charlene Evans, Missionary Sharon Forrester, hallelujah. Sister Dahlia Watts, Sister Claudia Duffus, glory to God. Sister Jennifer Higgins, Sister Olive Salmon, Sister Aideen Hibbert, Natalie Bartlett, glory to God. Maureen Smith, Sister Maureen, Sister Tanika Robinson, glory to God. Sister Jennifer Higgins, Sister Shanna King, glory to God. I don't know if I've missed any of the names, glory to God. But I'm just giving God thanks for each and every one of you who have made this program a success tonight. Without you, we couldn't have done it. And tonight, it's a pleasure and a blessing to have you. And we look forward, Sister Loretta Oxford Johnson, glory to God. And all the others, if I didn't call your name, please excuse me. I didn't do it purposely. But it is a blessing and a pleasure to have your Sister Paulette Mendez, Sister Brother Anthony Bullers, Lady Tammy, Sister Tammy Marit. She used to be one of our singer here. It has been a while. She hasn't come back, but we are giving God thanks for her tonight, watching with us. Glory to God. And all the others who have made tonight program a success, I just want to say a big thank you, and I look forward to seeing you next week as we continue. Glory to God.
Sister Diane is also watching, and we also have Sister Kim Taylor and Bishop Glenn Rice Sutton. I was on it.
Sister Mitz Zyers or something like that. She always came. I don't remember if that's her right name. Yes. So, at this time, Minister Sadie will come with the final word before we close and pronounce the benediction.
Amen. Amen. Glory. I just want to start off, I'm going to read something, but I just want to start off like what a message that Pastor Steadman gave, Brother Gerard, exaltation, Sister Shepherd. But I want to tell Sister Shepherd, that was my exaltation I was decided to speak on. And when I heard it, I said, oh my God, the Spirit of God is moving among us. Because that's exactly what I wanted was to speak about. But nevertheless, she did it. And she did a wonderful job, better than I would have done it, because I would have done it 2 seconds and 3 minutes. So she did it well. And I'm not one to preach here, but I just want to go back to a week Friday ago, we didn't come on because everybody was planning for Christmas. Last week Friday, it was New Year's Eve and everybody was going. But I just want to say, Christmas will come and Christmas will go, but Jesus Christ is always and always with us.
Amen.
Amen.
Always with us. And I just want to read something here. Life goes by so quickly. One day we are free, can be free, great. Sorry. Life goes by so quickly. One day we can feel great, the next day broken. This pandemic teaches us to appreciate the little things. Nothing is permanent. So be thankful for your blessing. Life is very precious. Keep me in your peace and let the blessing of the Lord be upon us. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you again, Minister Sadie. Always giving a word of encouragement. Glory to God. Always have something good for us, glory to God. The Christmas and all the season will pass, but one thing, Jesus. Christ,
the blood, we still remain under Jesus Christ.
Yes, he's always there with us. He never goes away.
He's in a season, out of season. He's always. So it doesn't matter what, where you go, with, and you can still call upon him. He hasn't gone away until next year, like Christmas. He is still here.
Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you again, Minister Sadie. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And at this time, we'll just pronounce the benediction.
Thanks for him. And of course, also, Sister Vivian Nicholson, I also want to thank her so much for her wonderful input into tonight's broadcast.
Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Oh, yeah. And now, may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, rest, remain, and abide with us all, both now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Love you all. Glory love you to all. God. Love you with the love of God.
Amen. Amen.
Continue to pray one for another. It doesn't matter where how far we are, but continue to keep everyone in your prayers. We all need each other's prayer. In the name of
wonderful Amen. Thought. God Amen. Bless you all. Have a wonderful night. God bless you and enjoy your weekend. See you in church.
God bless you. God bless you. Love you all.
Love you all too. Bless you.
Blessings.
Blessings.